Let us continue our discussion. We are discussing Unit 8, that is on logistics and supply chain management. We shall discuss the remaining part of the unit in this third video. So here we have taken up the learning objectives. It's basically based on the self-learning material that you have been studying. We need to understand the different channels of direct marketing. This is basically about direct marketing. And then I explain the advantages and disadvantages of direct marketing. So direct marketing, as you all know, right, all of you and me, everyone is experiencing direct marketing. So means what? The companies are directly reaching out to us with their products and services. So this direct marketing is one of the priorities of marketers today. And many times they are concerned about developing a long-term relationship with customers. Let's take the example of, say, airlines. The airlines companies use direct marketing. Say, the frequent flyers, right? And say, shops, malls, etc. Right? You are entitled to some cards. So whenever you visit them, whenever you make the payment, right, you are subjected to some discount. And you are entitled to receive some facilities. So one of the priorities of marketers today is to build long-term relationship with customers. And they will say the birthday cards, they will say some information materials to customers, basically to establish relationship. Airlines, hotels, suppose you are visiting, say, one particular hotel in which you stay, frequently you stay, and you the hotel knows about your priorities. Say the guest is diabetic. So next time when they will be asking for the food items to be served, so the beverage manager might ask you, sir, are you feeling okay with your diabetes? Is it under control? Should we serve this kind of food? So the guest is likely to be surprised that how do they know that I am diabetic? I am having some food priorities. So this is all about direct marketing. Means establishing the relationship with the customers and customizing the services, not the general services, to the specific requirements of the customers. So airlines, they will be knowing the food priorities. Suppose the previous time you had a window seat, so would you like to have the same seat? So this time this is not available, last time hope you enjoyed the flight. These are the ways and techniques of doing marketing through in a direct manner. So it's basically consumer direct channels to reach and deliver goods, services to customers without using marketing intermediaries. So this is called disintermediation. So no more usage of marketing intermediaries like wholesalers, distributors, retailers, etc. Direct. This is customer direct. That is direct marketing. So there are different channels of direct marketing. One is a direct mail, telemarketing, email marketing, direct response television marketing, direct selling. More or less philosophically, all these are direct to customers, but we may use varieties of modes. Suppose we may use direct mail. Earlier it was quite prevalent in 1960s, 70s, 80s, when there was no telephone, right? Facilities were very restricted, internet was not there, it was mostly direct mail. Even your online courses, ODL mode, the courses offered through ODL mode, it was known as correspondence courses. Means what? Directly from the education service provider to the education service user. So it means sending an announcement, offer, reminder, etc. to individual customers. The marketer might have a mailing list and they can send all the multimedia DVDs. This is a popular medium because it can reach the target market. And we see these direct mail pieces are sent, right? Many times the customers feel that these are junk mail. So that's why that needs to be avoided, that the customers don't get a feel of junk mail. So that this is important, somehow we need to convince the customers. So once they receive some kind of materials which are of use to them, they are likely to receive those in future. Another thing you all have experienced, even me, that is telemarketing. So in case of telemarketing, marketers contact consumers by phone. So how they are contacting the consumers by phone? Because they are giving their phone numbers and they are asking the consumers to make a phone call, and that's how they develop a database. So in telemarketing, the salesperson uses telephone to attract new customers. Many times you may have received from calls from HDFC Life Insurance, right, informing about some new insurance products or whether they would like to send their service personnel to visit you. These are all direct marketing examples. So the call centers are used to attract prospects and sell to existing customers. They provide the services and many times they establish their relationship with the direct contact so that they can specifically handle the customer related problems. Email marketing, that is also frequently used, and these are basically inexpensive and flexible as they can deliver text, videos and audios. Not only text, they can deliver text, videos and audios also. That's why this is also an important mode of direct marketing. And then direct response television marketing. Direct response television marketing, which is known as DRTP. You may have seen it in some TV channels, that it's a long form, which is usually half an hour, maybe long, going for 1 hour also. It's a long segment in which explains the product in detail. Suppose a vacuum cleaner, how does it operate it? Or say some, right, it, sometimes when this time also questioned also about the ethical aspects. But the marketers make the claim, they demonstrate, and they demonstrate all the things in a detailed manner. So that's why it requires time, half an hour to 1 hour. It's maybe short term, which refers to typical, right, 30 seconds also, or maybe 60 seconds, 1 minute commercials that ask viewers for an immediate response that this is the product, call us. This particular thing is open for 3 days. Please call us at this number. So that is basically seeking response from the television with the help of TV media. So that is DRTP, direct response television marketing. So for an immediate response, which means they ask their viewers to call immediately to the number given or say log on to the website. They will give details of the website also. They will give details about the products. They will give details about the phone numbers and they will make the required claims. And you have it, you feel it, you get it experience yourself. So have a discussion with our persons. So that is one aspect. Direct selling, it is the oldest medium of direct marketing, which means the sale of products by face-to-face contact with the customers. So nowadays, many companies are using it for professional salespersons, right? They are doing this. The propaganda gum distribution, or say in pharmaceuticals, right? The companies are selling, right, through the medical representatives. So it's more used by, say, insurance companies. It's mostly done by the insurance companies, stockbrokers, personal selling, face-to-face contact, that is widely prevalent. So advantages of direct marketing, it's flexible targeting. It's not mass. If you give an advertisement in a television, it will be true for all, anyone. But in case of direct marketing, it is flexible targeting. That we want to reach to the school teachers. So if we are having a database of the school teachers, so immediately we can send an SMS, a bulk SMS, or we can send a group email, right? We can send email to all the teachers. So we can have multiple uses. It's easy to manage. We can give the repeat delivery. If an SMS is delivered, if an email is delivered, it will be immediately received. Likewise, it will be immediately sent, means. Then testing capability, we can find out, suppose yesterday we sent 500 emails. Out of those 500 emails, we have suppose received 20 replies. Means what? We get a response rate. So these are all important. We can establish the relationship building. Suppose one particular guest has stayed in a hotel. So in the next day, or say, right, the person will receive an email that thank you for staying with us. Right, we look forward to give you the similar kind of services. Right, this is our toll-free number. This is our this thing. Right, please maintain relationship. We are glad to serve you. These are the messages. These are the information that we can provide to direct marketing only. So we can target message to defined customers. At the same time, we can geographically target also. Say we want to reach to the school teachers in Kamrup Rural District. So if we are having the database of the school teachers in Kamrup Rural District, we can specifically, geographically target them. So that is important. So with this, we have come to the end of Unit 8. So in Unit 8, it's all about logistics, supply chain management, and direct marketing. So you may have understood the basic aspects of logistics, supply chain management, and direct marketing. Ultimately, we are concerned about delivery of the right kind of products to the right type of customers at the right time, at the right places, with the least amount of cost. That is basically the essence of logistics and supply chain management. And if we can do that, the organizations, the companies will be in a better competitive position. They will be in a better position to serve their customers in the most efficient manner. Thank you.